good contingent from Minnesota. The Gopher crowd making some noise over there. A little flag up there. Last year we were almost done with the home season in Iowa City. We had all the meets on the front-loaded side. Four home meets were all just almost, I think, the first week of February, and we were done.
I know. It's nice to have it spread out.
Yep. Now we're getting kicked off here.
So G's going to start off the Hawkeye vault rotation with the Ochoco full. Very good landing. A little hop back, but she overall did a very good job.
Good start from Gianna. We'll move to the uneven bars. You'll have Soraya Johnson, also a freshman from Woodstock, Georgia.
Yes, so on the bars, judges are looking for handstands to finish on top of the bar, have good, clean lines throughout their routine, their releases to have a good amplitude, and obviously that stuck landing at the end of the routine is icing on the cake.
Soraya with a 9.85 last time against Penn State, so setting a good high bar as the freshman.
Beautiful handstand on top. Very nice dismount. One step on the landing, but overall very good routine.
Good solid, solid dismount there.
Yes, Minnesota's bars is always very clean with their landings and beautiful lines, so I'm excited to watch their bars.
Allison Zulke now, the junior from Waukesha, Wisconsin.
So Allison's vault's pretty unique. It is called the Zulke. It is named after her. What a nice vault.
Well performed there.
And if the vault happened too fast, what it is a front handspring onto the board, a half onto the horse, and a tuck pull off. Starting at a 10-0 value. And again, it is named after her, which is pretty unique.
And there probably aren't a ton of college athletes that have the vault named after them. Gianna Gerdes now on the uneven bars for Minnesota. She'll compete in the all-around again. She's been in all four events for all three of the events that Minnesota's competed in. She's a junior from Delaware, Ohio.
Yes, she's been a very solid competitor for the Gophers.
.975 for Masala and .97 for Johnson on their first routines for each team. So is she a little short on that handstand then? Is that great landing?
Yes, it was a very nice landing. She's a little short on the handstand. The judges necessarily want it on top or in that 90-degree angle.
Kendall LaPlante now up for Iowa. She's a junior from Seminole, Florida.
Yurchenko full. Start value is a 9.95 for a Yurchenko full. Let's see if she can zone in on this landing. Very nice.
Well done there. Next up for the Gophers, Marissa Jenks. A sophomore from Madison, South Dakota. Zulke scored a 9.875 on her vault. Gerdes 9.825 on her bar routine. Jinx. Karina Munoz now, the freshman. East Brunswick, New Jersey. She's done well on the vault, been in the 9-8 range to 9-8-5 in her three tries so far. Good one there. Allie Remlinger is up next. She's a senior. Don't get to say that very often these days. Winona, Minnesota.
Yes, she is one of the Gophers' Big Ten gymnasts to watch this year. She was named that before the season started.
Really strong finish to that performance. Linda Zivit up next for the Hawkeyes. She's a senior from Manhattan, Illinois.
Yes, and she will be our second vaulter in our lineup that has a 10-0 start value vault. She is going to be competing a soup full. Let's see if she can zone in on this landing. She has the last couple competitions. It's a strong vault. Very
oh,
nice.
Got it again.
She sticks the landing. Oh, and she's so excited.
She was a 9-9 at Ohio State last week. I think she's got a chance to see that number again.
Yes, that number again or higher. That's very nice.
Tiari Salais up next for the Gophers. She's a bar specialist. 9-9 her last time out in the duel against Penn State, so.
Yes, her bars is very beautiful to watch.
The Gophers had had a hard time on the bars, but it kind of figured it out last meet, so.
Beautiful routine so far. All the hand sets have been right on top of the bars. See if she can zone in and stick on this dismount. Do a double layout with a beautiful step landing. What a nice routine.
Very well done there. Cherquavia Henderson will finish it up for the Hawkeyes on the vault as far as the scoring goes.
Yeah, she is going to be doing a Yurchenko full. A slight hop back, but very nice vault from Q.
Another solid effort from Q. She also scored 9-9 last week at Ohio State. And then Maya Hooten will finish it up for the Gophers.
Yes,
a junior from Woodbury, Minnesota. She's got a pretty long accolade list so far. She's performed in the all-around in two of the three meets so far. She took the beam off last week against Penn State. But when you look at her scores from the Penn State meet, 9-9, 9-2-5, and 9-9-5. So
yes, Maya is an exceptional gymnast. She is also the Gophers' other Big Ten gymnast to watch this year.
Linda Zivit, 9-9-7-5.
That's awesome. So the two judges their scores combined, and one was a 9.95 from the judge, and another judge gave her a 10, so that's why it was a 9.75. Beautiful height on her release into immediate bail. Little shy of that handstand, but beautiful form. With a stuck landing. Very nice routine from Maya Hooten.
She certainly lived up to the billing there, didn't she?
Yes, she does.
Avery Chambers now will do an exhibition vault for the Hawkeyes, the freshman from Lombard, Illinois.
She's also doing her Yurchenko full slight hop back, but it's nice to see her getting her time in his exhibition and being able to get that experience.
The Hawkeyes will score a 49.375, which is their season high on the vault. Minnesota still waiting for Maya's to be scored, so we'll see where they end up. They're set at 49 right now. And then Maya Alberton, senior from Houston, Texas, will do an exhibition routine on the bars for the Gophers.
Beautiful handstand on top of the bar. Very nice release. A little short on that handstand. Very nice bar routine.
Good solid routine there. Give Minnesota 49.175. And so that'll be, they were led by Maya Hooten with a 9.875 and Tiari Solis with a 9.875. And of course, Linda Zivit led the Hawks with 9.975.
Yes, Linda really did crush the vault lineup.
So good solid performance there. So now we'll switch apparatus. Hawkeyes will move to the uneven bars. The Gophers will switch over to the vault. And so we've got a little bit of time. We're going to take a short break here, kind of get everything organized, and we'll come back. You're watching Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
Trust Dodge Street Tire for Hawks Auto Repair. with Aaron Trillo Tire. Dot Street Tire Line is celebrating over 30 good years on the corner of Huntington Church Street. Big Ten Gymnastics Championships are coming back to Iowa. March 18, Iowa Gymnastics will host the Big Ten Championships at Extreme Arena. Get your tickets now on the Hawkeye Mobile app or at HawkeyeSports.com.
Welcome back to Big Ten Gymnastics. I'm John Evans, along with Kira Hayden. Hawks after one rotation lead 49.375 to 49.175. So pretty high quality gymnastics there to kick off the meet. About to start the second rotation here. Minnesota will be on the vault. Iowa will be on the uneven bars. Going to get everything organized here. Syria Johnson will start for the Gophers on the vault. And she's performed the all-around the last two meets for the Gophers. Been a pretty consistent former. Had a little trouble on the beam against Penn State, but otherwise put up some really solid numbers. 39.35 in the Wasatch Classic. So,
yes, the beam is, you know, one of those moments where you're either going to hit or you're not going to hit. And it's a little tough thing.
Well, we joked about it last year. I'm not even sure I could walk safely across the beam. So forget jumping, flipping, any turning, any of that. So I think we're...
Got the crowd starting up the Let's Go Hawks. That's exciting.
The Gopher fans have been very energetic, so the Hawkeye fans finally decided to push back.
Yes.
Here's Johnson.
She opened up a Stukachenko full. What a nice vault.
Great start there for her. We'll move to Allison Zulke now on the bars.
Very nice handstand into a Hindorf. Another great handstand into a Pat. With a half pirouette, she's going to finish off her routine with a little shy handstand, but a full pirouette into a double tuck. A little hop back, but what a wonderful routine.
She's been very consistent so far in the three meets so far in that 9-8 range again, all three times there.
Yes, she's been a great leadoff for this bar squad.
Sarah Murrah, the freshman from Holland, Michigan now for the Gophers.
She's doing a Yurchenko full. Slight step back, but you know, a step is better than a big hop back.
And next up for the Hawks, Marissa Rojas, sophomore from Canton, Michigan. Did I label it up wrong? I did my math wrong.
No, I believe it's Karina McSweeney.
I miss Karina.
She was a late add, so you're good.
So Karina McSweeney will be up for the Hawks.
Yes, and she is new to this bar lineup. You know, last year she wasn't in the bar lineup. She did a couple exhibitions. So it's really nice to see her, you know, getting her time in and getting in the bar lineup. Going to do a blind change into a pike jäger. Little form break into an immediate bail. See if we can hit this handstand on top of the bar. Very nice. And she's going to end it with a half in, half out dismount to a stuck landing. What a great routine. She's stuck.
Pretty darn good there.
She will be very happy with that.
Hallie Remlinger now for the Gophers. 9-8-5 for Soraya Johnson. 9-8 for Sarah Murrah.
And Hallie just did a tuck Yurchenko 1.5, so that is out of a 10-0 start value.
You saw there, you'd mentioned those lines before. You could see that time took the step and got outside the line. I assume there's some deduction there for being then outside of the...
Yes. Depending on how big of a step outside of that white line will determine the deduction from the judges.
Now we get Marissa Rojas up for the Hawkeyes.
Yes, we do.
Thank you. Selke scored 9.775. Haven't posted a score yet for McSweeney.
What a nice handstand on top of the bar. He's going to do a toe head into a ginger. Little bit of leg separation. Nice handstand. Into an overshoot to handstand. Little over. And her dismount is going to be a half in, half out. And it's really hard to do that from just her cast handstand. So that was a very nice routine from Marissa Rojas.
Gianna Gerdes will be the fourth vaulter for the Gophers.
She's doing your Kinga 1.5, a very nice landing with a slight step forward. What a very nice form in the air.
Right now I'm like double checking the names every time I spit one out. Kendall LaPlante now will be next up for the Hawkeyes.
Yes, and she is new to this lineup this year, and she has been killing it meet after meet.
9-9 at Ohio State last week, so yes. Fantastic career high there.
Yes, it's been really exciting to watch her in the bar lineup. I know bars, she has said that it was not her favorite event, and now she's just excited to be doing it.
Team scores on the vault tend, or the performance scores tend to come out faster on the vault. 9.875 for Gianna Gerdes, 9.85 for Johnson, Sarah Murad 9.8, and Hallie Remlinger 9.775. Karina McSweeney with a 9.8 on the vault, or I'm sorry, on the bars as well.
So she cast it over on her first handstand. She's going to come down, regroup, probably talk with Coach Hayden and see where they want to go from there. And it does just count as a fall. So.
And so just a reminder, those six performers, so you hope that this is when you need your teammates to pick you up because you only count five scores for the team race. So Hawkeyes will have two more athletes to compete, and we'll know that their score is probably going to count, or they'll want it to count. So,
yes, they will be looking to drop this score, but now she has to get back up and do the best that she can do, just in case there is another one. She will start over. She will do a straddle Jaeger into an immediate bail.
Is there a time limit for how long they can kind of regroup?
They have 30 seconds, as long as there's no injury. She seems to be doing okay. She's joking around with her friends, and she's just going to breathe and finish strong.
I would assume everybody that's ever been on one of these has had that happen to them at some point.
Yes, most likely. Beautiful double layout.
Maddie Quarles up next for the Gophers, the redshirt senior from Andover, Minnesota. She's a vault specialist, 9.9 last week at Penn State.
Yes, she has a beautiful vault. She is going to do a Yurchenko 1.5. Slight off to the side, but just a slight hop forward, and that was a beautiful
Is this one of those where if you're on the line, you're in, or you're on the line, you're out?
I think it just depends on the judges, because they are looking at that directional. The lines are based on your direction. So I would believe that they would take a little bit for that.
A good all-around vault, though. Adeline Kenlin up next for the Hawks. She's a junior here from Iowa City.
Yes, it's nice to see her back in the bar lineup. At the beginning, they were resting her arm, and there was no injury, but they just wanted to be safe that the arm was okay. So it's nice to see her swing, because her lines are just gorgeous.
I asked both coaches about kind of load management. How do you, if you want your athlete to be in the all-around at the end of the year, but maybe you try to break them into it gently, how do you get them to the right place, and do you kind of shuffle pieces around? How do you do that? And that's part of it is, especially if you have some depth at the position, it allows you to keep somebody else performing and get some experience as well.
Yes. Beautiful handstand on top of the bar into a toe handstand. She's going to do a Maloney into a pack with the switch kip. Little shy of that handstand into a toe full with full pirouette, stuck landing on that double tuck. What a beautiful bar routine from Adeline.
Strong response there and a half two performance from Adeline Kenlin.
Yes, she knew she needed to step in and, you know, help the team, and she did what she was supposed to.
And Maya Hooten will finish up the scoring for the Gophers on the vault.
Maya's ball is beautiful to watch. She will do a Yurchenko 1.5. Slight hop back, so the judges will take.
Pretty strong finish there. And the Hawks will turn to their anchor, Karina Munoz. Big spot for a freshman here.
Yes, and she can definitely lead up to it.
So Minnesota, good scores on the vault. Still waiting on that last one, but as they sit as a team now, 49.175. And I would think Maya's is pretty good, and that's going to hold up there.
Yes, so Karina is going to do a cow hop to a piked Jaeger. Very nice. Beautiful handstand on top, into a bail handstand, a little bit of a form break and over. And she's going to finish with a free hit to an immediate double layout, which is very hard to do. Step landing. What a great routine from the freshman, Karina.
She did that exceptionally well. That's from your last two gymnasts there, that's a pretty big answer after watching two falls, knowing you have to perform to come up and really dig deep and get it done.
Yes, you know, it looks like they blocked it out. They got it out of their heads. They just focused on their bar routine, and they hit it, and that's what they needed to do.
And you could see with Adeline talking to her beforehand, you could see Adeline was staying loose. So certainly the pressure wasn't wearing on her at that point, and showed well. We've got an exhibition vault here. That was Lauren Pearl.
Yeah, she did a very nice controlled Yurchenko full. She only had a step back, which is, again, better than having the hop back.
And Gianna Masella, again, kind of a good place to get a freshman some additional experience in this exhibition part. Gophers will finish the vault at 49.3 as Maya Hooten rolls out a 9.9.
Yes, so Gianna on bars as a freshman, she's still trying to find her way into the bar lineup, but the exhibition is doing great, getting her into the lineup and figuring out what she needs to fix.
So Linda Zivit will win the vault. Good for performance from her tonight.
Little sort of that handstand into a blind change, Pike Jaeger. A little bit of flex speed on that. Nice handstand. She's going to pass handstand veil. Nice handstand into a double layout. Let's see if she can find that stick. Slightly hop back, but that was a good routine from G.
And again, great experience for the freshman to get out there, perform the routine in front of a good crowd. So again, Linda Zivit wins the vault, 9.975. Maya Hooten, 9.9. On the bars, we'll have, let's make sure we got all of the scores in. We did. So on the bars, we'll have a three-way tie. Maya Hooten will end up winning the race there. Tiari Solis and Adeline Kenlin all at 9.875. So those three will share the individual title there. As the Gophers go for 49.3 on the vault, 49.175 on the bars. Iowa goes 49.375 on the vault and 49.025 on the bars. And so through two events, we're at halftime. Minnesota has a small lead, 98.475 to 98.4. So kind of as we expect at the beginning, a good competitive meet, good close scoring.
Yes.
And then it'll be really, the Gophers will start on the floor and Iowa will be on the beam, and then Gophers will finish up on the event that's kind of been their challenge so far this year. So be interesting to watch. We've got a little bit of time here. We're going to take a quick timeout. You are watching Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
you can do on social media right now is follow official Jim Hines accounts. Follow us, Iowa Gymnastics, on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for exclusive news, photos, and videos of the team.
Welcome back to Carver Hawkeye Arena and Big Ten Gymnastics. Kira Hayden, John Evans here. Good solid meet through the first two apparatus. 98.475 for Minnesota, 98.4 for the Hawks.
Yes, I can see it being a close meet up until the end.
Both teams are very good on the floor, and Iowa might have a slight advantage on the bars, and that'll be if Iowa can perform as we've talked about. Doesn't take much to get off, and all of a sudden scores can get way out of whack in a hurry.
Yes. So on the balance beam, what judges are potentially looking for are nice form, and what that means is, you know, straight legs, pointed toes on their elements on the beam. Overall, nice flow of the routine without your wobbles, and then finding that stuck landing at the end of the routine.
Jerquavia Henderson to kick off for the Hawkeyes.
Yes, and she has been a strong leadoff for us on the balance beam. She's going to do a handspring layout. Very nice finish. Very nice leap series. The judges are really looking for those leaps and jumps to reach that 180 or greater. She's going to finish her routine with a round-off double tuck, and there's not many gymnasts in the NCAA that still compete this. What a very nice routine from.
Is that a dismount where she can really kind of show her power? I mean, she's a
yes.
powerful jumper and tumbler.
Yes, it's not a very common element.
Marissa Jenks will kick it off for the Gophers. Probably Minnesota's best event. And in the low, pushing up in the mids, 49-4, 49-3 in the last two tries here.
Yes, so Jenny loves putting floor routines together, so she works with the girls and puts these wonderful floor routines together with beautiful choreography. Very nice opening pass. Very nice jump series. We'll be right back. the judges are really looking for controlled landings on each of their passes. Their leaps to make it the entire way around and also reaching that 180 or above mark. Staying in bounds, obviously, and there's this white mat around the outside of the floor, and that is where the out-of-bounds line is, and having good artistry in the dance. Very nice last pass.
Good opening routine there for the Gophers.
Yes, she did a very nice job for them.
Allison Zelke now again. Be on the beam for the Hawkeyes.
So Z is new to the beam lineup this season. She wasn't in beam lineup last year. And, you know, she's still making her mark in this beam lineup, which is really good. She's going to open up with a triple series, which is a pretty difficult thing because you can be off in the slightest bit and your series can cause you to fall. Very nice leaps.
We kind of joked about before, you might challenge me to take three steps across that beam, let alone take three solid flips like that.
Yes. Just landing on her disc mount. What a nice routine from Z.
She is fired up about that. Great performance there. 9-7-7-5 for Q, the opener for the Hawkeyes. But Brooklyn Rahway now. She's a freshman, and she's actually from Central Iowa over in Carlisle. Nine, seven, seven, five for Jenks to start off the Minnesota routine.
Opening pass. Judges would probably like to see a little bit cleaner landing and not so much of a hop, but very nice. Dancing right into a second pass. Nana Pinskin double tuck. A little bit more control on that landing. Very nice loop series. What a very nice routine.
Nine, seven, five for Zelke. That'll bring up Alexa Ebling, senior from Adel, Iowa.
But she is also new to this beam lineup, wasn't in it last year, so we had a lot of seniors in the beam lineup last year, so a lot of freshmen and sophomores are jumping into this lineup. Opening up with a handspring layout, very solid. Beautiful full turn. Very nice jump. Judges probably want to see her head go back a little bit further on that ring leap. Very solid front aerial. She is nailing this routine. She's going to finish off with a gainer pike and see if she can find this landing. And she does. She sticks the landing. What a wonderful routine from Alexa.
Very nicely done. 9-8 for Brooklyn Rahway. That'll bring up Gianna Gertis. This was about this time last year was when Iowa went up to Minnesota for the duel. And Minnesota set their all-time career high in that dual meet. So get a little bit of a reload here, but still a lot of quality out here.
Yes, these two teams are very well put together and have some great gymnasts in them. Open to the team with a pump front run across the double tuck. Very nice landing on that. She is just sliding across the floor. Very pretty dance work. Taking a breather before this pass. Randall Houston double fight. Little slide back of her front foot.
Very nicely done there from Gertis. Hawkeyes will have Aubrey Nick up next, the junior. Alexa Ebling had a 9.8 was her score, so good scores so far for the Hawkeyes.
Added into being routines is a judging change, and routines have to end their routine with a dismount that is valued at a C. So a lot of gymnasts in the NCAA had to rework their routines and change their dismounts. Beautiful stuck round off 1.5 from Aubrey Nick. What a wonderful routine.
Gianna Gertis with a 9.85 on the floor. Next up for the Gophers, Soraya Johnson. The freshman's been very good so far. 9.9 and a 9.85 in her two scored competitions.
Yeah, seeing her warm up, her floor seems very energetic, very fun, and I'm excited to see it. First half, very controlled landing. Presentation is very nice throughout her routine, constantly looking up and making it aware that she wants to be owning the floor. Finishing with a round-off, double tuck, very nice pass. It almost stuck landing.
That probably is going to have a pretty good number attached to it.
I would say so. And the team seems to be very excited for her.
9.875 for Aubrey Nick.
Yes, that's a very nice routine, and she deserved that score.
Marissa Rojas up next.
Going to open her routine with a handspring layout. Step out. Beautiful. Very nice full turn. Dancing right out of it. Very nice jump start. Little hop back, couldn't quite get the stick, but very nice routine from Marissa Rojas.
Hallie Remlinger up next.
Yes, and she was one of their Big Ten gymnasts to watch, so I'm excited to see her flow routine.
9.85 from Soraya Johnson as well.
Very nice opening pass. Is right out of that pass.
I always like it when you watch the teammates surrounding the mat that are doing the routine as they're doing it on the floor.
Yes, you know, they are constantly doing these practice routines in the gym when they're practicing, so the girls learn all the moves and just do it with the girl on the floor. Very nice routine.
9.8 for Marissa Rojas. And if you're going to turn to an anchor, the national runner-up is probably a pretty good anchor in Adeline Kenlon.
Yes, she is a fierce beam queen. To open her team with a handspring layout. Step out. Beautiful. Benelia right into her leap. Beautifully done. Her lines are just beautiful on this event. Full turn, dancing right out of it. Into a stuck landing. What a gorgeous routine from Adeline.
Pretty well done. Her teammates recognize that. And Maya Hooten will have the anchor spot for the Gophers.
Yes, and if we're going from a beam queen, we're going to a floor queen right now. Her floor queen is just exquisite.
She posted the first perfect 10 of her career and the first Gopher in program history as a freshman in 2021 on the floor.
What a gorgeous opening pass, so high.
Just makes it look easy.
She really does. Now she's getting into the dance moves with her teammates. Always makes it fun. Beautiful jump. Very nice pass. She just floats that front tight gap.
Wow.
What a stuck landing on that last pass. What a very nice routine from Maya Hooten. I could see her getting a very good score on that routine.
Karina Munoz will head to the beam to do an exhibition routine.
Yes, and her routine is very fierce. You can just see everything is purposeful and she means it. Very nice. Had a little wobble, but she was able to cover it up very well. Sounds like she's got her beam music on, so she's just jamming. Step out and then hopped right back up.
That was the angry regroup.
This is what the exhibition is for. It's to get your, you know, jitters out on beam. It's to get used to the competing in the new arena. There's so many things that go into play with this arena.
Good finish there for her. So 49.15 for the Hawkeyes, led by Adeline Kendlin's 9.9. And then we go to Minnesota. 49.375, led by Maya Hooten's 9.975. Some judge decided it wasn't quite worth the 10, but it was pretty darn close. And so Emily Cook will be doing now an exhibition.
Yes, she was in their lineup last weekend but had a little bit of a mess up, so they're probably just trying to get her back into the swing of things and being in their lineup.
That was very nicely done. As that'll finish up rotation number three, Gophers hold a slim lead through three rotations, 147.85 to 147.55. So,
yes, it looks like it'll come down to the last event.
come down to the last one. Gophers will have to probably, again, might need a season high to go ahead and, if they want to hold on and keep the Hawkeyes at bay here. Seeing the Hawkeyes move to probably one of their better events. And so it's a tough switch if you're on the Gopher scorekeeping side, but a chance for the Hawkeyes to make up that 3-10 deficit here.
Yes, for sure. The Hawkeyes are about to have a floor dance party.
We're going to take a quick break. You are watching Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Arena and Big Ten Gymnastics, John Evans, Kira Hayden, as we prepare for the final rotation. You know, one of the things we saw a great video before the meet started, and then I believe it was after the first rotation, the new Iowa women's wrestling team was introduced to the crowd as well. The video was Title IX, the 50 years of women's sports. Pretty cool deal. I mean, there were Iowa coaches that narrated it, and it was a really neat deal.
Yes, it was very inspiring. You know, all of the words for that entire video came from head coach Larissa Libby, and she really put into a lot of thought with the video and who she wanted to speak throughout the video as well. And, you know, it's just remarkable that we were able to have the Iowa women's wrestling program here tonight to, you know, introduce them, because it's such a huge milestone of them creating a path for younger females. Just another sport for girls to do.
And the Gopher fans care enough about wrestling as well that even they were applauding the Iowa women's wrestling team.
Yes.
So it crosses enemy lines, so to speak.
Yes, we're hoping to get more, you know, women's Big Ten programs.
Emily Cook will be the first beam participant for the Gophers. As you mentioned, during her exhibition routine, had a little bit of an off meet against Penn State, had a tough floor routine, and probably didn't have her best beam day either. And so she'll look to get back kind of on the right side of the scoring here tonight.
Yes, you know, she's had floor tonight with exhibition, you know, maybe a little less nerves being in the exhibition spot, but she did a great job on floor, and she's going to lead off this team, and I think she'll do a great job.
And she has a career high at 9.925 on the beam, so.
Yes, her beam is beautiful work. She's super tall and thin, and that just gives you beautiful lines on the balance beam. Very nice full turn. She's gonna open it with a hamstring layout step out. Little wobble, but she's able to bring it back and finish. Nice sweep. We'd like to see a little bit more split to 180. Very nice. That is very hard to do because she's landing on one leg. It's very controlled and very pretty. She's going to finish with a round of 1.5. Almost got the stuck landing. Had to take a hop back, but a very nice start for the Gophers.
You could see as she prepared for that one-footed landing, you could see the concentration etched on her face.
Yes, she was running through her beam cues, I'm assuming.
Aubrey Nicknow will start the Hawkeye floor rotation.
Yeah, she's going to bring us a dance party for sure. She's going to open her routine with a front double fold. Very nice.
I think she did that to you.
I think she did. Dancing it out, you know, everyone along the line of teammates knows it. She just did a beautiful switch wing to a switch half for her leap series. Very controlled landing. Very nice second pass. her routine with the peace sign. What a fun routine to open up for the Hawkeyes floor party.
What's disappointing for me is all of the things that I know I can't do, and then she dances like that, and I know I can't do that either. So, so give Cook a 9.65 to start the beam. Ella Searord now.
Starting off with a very unique mount. Very nice full turn. Can't swing here, so about, couldn't quite get the landing on that, so she had to fall. She's gonna hop back up, she's gonna just brush it out from what just happened, and she's going to finish strong. Pretty late. Very nice finish. Couldn't get the stick, but had to take a slight step, but very nice beam.
9.6 for Aubrey Nick on the floor. Name that might sound familiar now. Next up for the Hawkeyes, Bailey Libby. Getting a little pep talk from, was that coach or was that mom?
I think she calls it both. Bailey's gonna open her pass with a front double fold. Beautiful. Her floor routine is just a beautiful artistry to her. She really knows how to just dance and let it flow. She's gonna do a back 1.5. Punch front layout with a beautiful landing. Switching to a stick half. Gonna dance it out into the corner to Karina. Gonna end this routine with a Rudy. And what a beautiful floor routine from the freshman, Bailey.
I know Coach Libby well enough to know that she thinks of all the girls as her daughters, but that one's probably a little different.
That's a very special moment. I know it gives me the chills, so it has to give her mother the chills.
Soraya Johnson now up for the Gophers. 9-1 for Ella Seord.
Very nice full turn. One second there, Henson. Step out. Very nice and controlled. Beautiful. Let's offense, two teams, the front four, very nice.
You could definitely see her being one of the Gophers as the years go on, and she just continues to improve.
Yes, for sure.
Up next for the Hawkeyes, the gymnast that I don't know that I've ever seen without a smile on her face, Linda Zivit, giving 9.825 to Bailey Libby.
Yeah, Linda makes floor super fun. Such a powerhouse. Opening up with the front three, round up, back in some double touch. Beautiful work. Going to do a push through half into a split full. Very pretty. Last pass. Very nice finish to this wonderful powerhouse board team. What a beautiful routine from Linda. I just love watching her floor.
Very nicely done there. Up next for the Gophers, Gianna Gertis. Soraya Johnson with a 9.775 on her routine. Hawkeyes have edged into the lead here, but Minnesota will be trying to get rid of that 9-1.
Yes, and they still have the option to get rid of it. Beautiful front aerial. That's interesting layout. Step out, very nice and controlled.
Adeline Kendlin playing in the chalk here in front of us.
She's just making me laugh. A very nice routine so far.
Very well done from Gertis.
Put the heels together, very nice.
She fought that landing and held on. Karina Munoz will follow up Linda Zivit's 9.875.
Karina is something else on this floor. She really commands the attention. Just watch the look in her eyes. She's going to open up with a front through two double tuck. Little hop back.
With such an explosive landing, she kind of bounced.
Yes, she will receive a direction for that. Very nice and controlled switch half to Wolf Bowl. Pass is not a pinching double pipe to a stuck landing. What a way to end.
After her fall on the beam, that's a pretty good finish up for her.
Yes.
So if it gets close north, we can stay a lot less.
What a fun routine.
Gianna Gerdes with a 9.825 will open the way for Brooklyn Rowery.
Very solid. Looking very confident up on that beam. Very beautiful leap. She is looking very solid for the Gophers. Little bubble on that turn. Finishing the routine with a round of 1.5 step landing. What a nice beam routine from Brooklyn.
Strong performance for the Iowa high schooler. Brink coming back to her home state. Adeline Kenlin now on the floor for the Hawks. 9.725 for Munoz.
So Ads is performing a brand new routine this year. And Larissa spends a lot of time choreographing these and making them be as perfect as they can be. It takes a lot of pride into choreographing for these girls. She's gonna open with a front double full. Beautifully danced out.
Can you cover a landing kind of with that step or dance move or kind of a...
Yes, you can.
You just immediately transition kind of into the next thing?
Yep. Her leap series is very difficult. She's going to do a switch-through connected to a Ferrari leap. And not many people in the NCAA do that. Trying to finish this routine with a round off 1.5 front layout to a beautiful scale. What a wonderful routine from Adeline.
Might have heard a cheer during the routine there from the Minnesota contingent. That was a 9.9 for Brooklyn Rowery.
She had a beautiful routine.
Sarah Murrah up next.
Yes, as the beam anchor.
She's kind of the key to the meet here to try to get rid of the 9.1.
Very nice full turn. Her team layout step out very solid. Little balance check on that. Very nice. Steph Landon. What a finish by the Gophers on the balance beam.
Great performance, and all five had to really come through, knowing after that first one, and they really came to play.
Yes, they really knew that they needed to get rid of that 9-1, and that's what they did.
And the Hawks will finish up with Jerquavia Henderson.
She also has a new routine this year. It's super fun.
9-9-2-5 for Adeline Kentland.
It's a great score. She is going to open up with a beautiful full in.
What height.
Wonderful. She had such control on that landing. Her leaps are going to be a switch side into a popa saddle jump. Very controlled. Everyone's getting into the dance moves over here. She's going to finish her routine with a front through to double touch. Beautiful landing! And a strong finish for the Hawks on floor. I think that's going to be a pretty big score.
So we've got a Minnesota finishes with a 9. A 9-9. And a 9-8-7-5 from Sarah Murrah. So, yep. Hawkeyes are going to need a 9-9-7-5 from Q to tie the meet.
Okay, we have Maya Hooten going on for Minnesota. Maya Hooten.
And they got the 9-9-7-5, so we're going to be tied. As one judge gave her a 10, one gave her a 9-9-5. So we talked early on about the younger participants maybe getting the action on the apparatus. So with somebody like Maya, what's the idea here?
So I believe last week she was in lineup, and they had a couple things happen in their beam lineup, so they could just be giving her a little bit of a break necessarily for the competition side of things, but her beam is beautiful regardless.
I want to make sure she stays sharp just in case.
Beautiful beam routine.
Hannah Castillo, the freshman, will also get a go now for Iowa.
With a front three to double pipe. This is her first time competing at Carver, but in exhibition for this whole season so far. So I think what Larissa is looking for is she had a good practice this week, so they wanted to put her in the exhibition spot and see what she can give them.
So do the judges, I know they don't post an official score, but do the judges judge it anyway, almost for practice for them as well?
Yes, they do. They judge it just like she's competing in the actual lineup, because the coaches also want to see what she could potentially score if she were in lineup as well. just finished her routine with a double tuck. Very nice routine from the freshman, Hannah.
So, Iowa finishes. Iowa finishes the floor with a 49.325. Minnesota finishes the beam with a season high 49.025. And that leads us to a tie. 196.875. So strong performances all around. We'll run through real quick before they go to the cha-cha slide, because I know you're going to bounce out there to do that. So going back real quick, Linda Zivit's going to win the vault, 9.975. The bars, three-way tie, Maya Hooten, Adeline Kenlin, Tiari Salais at 9.875. On the beam, we're going to share that one as well. Adeline Kenlin and Brooklyn Rowway, 9.9. And on the floor, Maya Hooten and Jerquavia Henderson, 9.975. So, again, very high-level performance tonight.
Yes, and, you know, that was what we expected coming into this. Both teams are very well put together and have very good gymnastics, and it was overall a great meet.
All right, so we think we know the results. We're pretty sure we know the results, but we're going to go ahead and take a break. We'll come back as they come out. Again, we're going to get, they do the cha-cha slide here while they're adding everything up, tallying everything, making sure there's no mistakes. But we'll take a quick break. We'll be back for the award ceremony. You're watching Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Carver Hawkeye Arena. Just tallying up scores here. As the Hawkeyes just raised a banner for last year's Sweet 16 team. That was kind of cool.
Yes, and I was at that meet last year, and it was such a fun, enthusiastic meet.
So again, Hawkeyes finish, actually both teams finish at 196.875. That's a season high by a good number for the Gophers, as they were previous best was 196.325. Is really the key for them tonight was figuring out their vault. That had been kind of what had been holding them back, and posted a pretty good score tonight on the vault.
Yes, overall.
Or I'm sorry, on the beam.
Overall, like, each team did very well on the events. Obviously, they're going to come back into practice on Monday and know what they need to fix and make better, because there were minor mistakes. But it was such a fun meet, and I can't say that I've been at a meet that has ended in a tie. So that's exciting.
Last week, Iowa posted the fifth best score in school history at 196.9. Tonight, right on that at 196.875. So good performance there. I guess when I ran through the events, I neglected Gianna Gertis will end up as the all-around champion today, 39.375. So good, solid performance on all four events for her.
Yes, she had a great meet.
They did not cha-cha slide there. They promised cha-cha slide. They did not do it.
I know. Maybe they're saving it for after awards. I don't know.
So I think we should be. So we announce an MVP for each team, and then obviously the event winners. And no team winner tonight.
Yes.
We'll all get to celebrate.
Everyone's a winner.
Exactly. But again, for relatively early in the season, you saw good, solid performances, and you saw something that if you're Coach Libby and you're Coach Hansen, there's probably a lot that you think, this is good, let's build on this.
Yes, you know, all the coaches should be super proud of their teams this evening. They put up a fight for sure. Whenever, you know, someone fell in the lineup, the girls stepped up. So they know that their practice is being put into play.
Got all the teams lined up here, just kind of waiting for the grand finale here.
Looks like the head women's wrestling coach is going to be passing out the roses to the girls.
Oh, very nice. I had heard at one of the breaks, I'd heard them behind us talking about, you were telling me your parents are at the Iowa Penn State wrestling meet. I heard somebody telling me about it, or I heard somebody talking about it behind us.
I want to see how it's going.
Steal a quick look. I know we're a gymnastics broadcast tonight, but like Iowa leads through 157, 11-9, so. Spencer Lee wasn't able to get a pin tonight. He only won 18-2.
I'm sure it's a fun meet to be that. Oh, sorry, a fun match to be at.
Yeah, there aren't a ton of schools that do it as well in wrestling as Iowa does, but Penn State is certainly one that does.
Mm-hmm.
when I was talking to Coach Hansen on the phone this week, she said that this is probably the closest team that she's ever coached. Again, they're different than what they've been in the past, but they're a very close-knit group, and they really, really look out for each other. And, you know, instead of having that superstar, it's really kind of a team collective effort. There are a couple of outstanding gymnasts and all around, but you do have a lot more pieces contributing, you know, an event here or two events here, as maybe they did last year, where it might have been three or four that were doing the all around.
Yes, you know, it's always exciting and interesting to see how the teams rebuild that relationship, you know, when seniors leave and freshmen come in. And I always think it's exciting and nice to see that the teams can, you know, put aside all the differences and still be one.
Well, again, we talked about that with the floor routines. I mean, there's a lot of people that were lining the floor that haven't been on any of the events, and yet they're all there cheering, supporting their teammates. When they were on the beam, you could see it was almost like a choir stage that they were all kind of on and cheering and supporting.
Yes.
On the beam.
They know that the teammates are very supportive, and each one of them have each other's backs.
StatCast had these numbers. I'm not sure what we're waiting on here, as I see the guys hustling behind us here, so we might be pretty close to our official announcements. I was talking to the event crew before the meet started, and there's a women's basketball game here at noon tomorrow. So everything you see has to get torn down, cleaned up. Basketball floor has to get put back down.
Yes.
And get ready to play. It was funny because as he was joking, the biggest problem was all the chalk. Of how do you clean up all the chalk around?
I know when Quest comes home from coaching bars, he obviously the colors are black, so he's working with chalk that's white, and he just comes home covered in white.
Like the kid in grade school that just rolled along the chalkboard.
The first award goes to the state-owned MVP from Minnesota, Brooklyn Rowery.
So Brooklyn, the Carlisle, Iowa native, got the MVP award for the Gophers.
Jerquavia Henderson.
And Q gets it for the Hawkeyes, Jerquavia Henderson. Linda Zivit announced as the winner.
First place on the bars, we have a three-way tie with scores of 9.875. For Minnesota, Maya Hooten. And for Minnesota, Tiara Solace.
So Hooten and Solace getting recognized for the bar title.
Kenlin.
And Adeline Kenlin. Adeline and Brooklyn will get their names called again. Great scores at 9-9. Now the PA announcer switched to Rowery on how to say her name, so either I've screwed it up all night or we've switched here in the middle.
First place on the floor, we have a two-way tie with scores of 9.975.
Maya Hooten and Jerquavia Henderson again at 9.975. Both of them talked one judge into a 10, but couldn't talk the other one into a 10.
Yes.
And our all-around winner for tonight, with a score of 39.375, from Minnesota, Gianna.
And congratulations to Gianna Gertis for the overall title, the all-around. Coach Clarissa wants to hand out flowers and hugs, but nobody's ready for this. A two-way tie and a duel.
Yes.
Congratulations to both teams. Again, we started off the broadcast with this should be a very close, very evenly matched duel. The teams have kind of flip-flopped. We end the duel with nothing really settled.
Yes, it is still open.
A good solid finish. And that'll do it for tonight. Any closing thoughts?
No, not that I haven't said already.
You and I will be back together in 2 weeks, February 11th.
Yes,
against Michigan State. Iowa will be back at home. A big thank you to our camera people and the gang back in the control room. For Kira, I'm John Evans. Thank you for watching Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Have a great weekend.